All right, so now we've seen how we can store one bit using a latch, and if you are tracking with what we did last time, you should be guessing that the next thing we're going to do is we're going to take these one-bit latches and extend them to multi-bit latches and eventually to the registers that we will need for our register file. And you'd be right, but first we need to pause and introduce another concept called a clock. So a clock provides this oscillating signal that just turns on and off at a fixed interval, and we often use this as the set signal for our latches. And the motivation here is that it keeps our computation and our memory in sync so that the memory is not changing while the computation is taking place. So once we take a latch and we make it set signal a clock, now it becomes a flip-flop. And this is what stores a value for a particular duration so that we can do computation. So the clock period is the inverse of its frequency, which is measured in hertz. And so basically the clock period is just the length of time that a CPU has to do the next cycle of calculations before the memory sets again. And so it's sort of the minimum time that an instruction will take to execute. So there are a bunch of different flip-flop types depending on how they're wired up and how they use the clock. So there's SR and D, which we talked about. There's T and JK, which we aren't really going to cover too much in this course. But the point is that all of these can be used to build the others, and they can all also be built from basic logic gates in multiple ways. So in some sense, they're all equivalent. They're all ways in which you store one bit using a clocked latch or a flip-flop. Okay, so now we get to registers. And as you might imagine, we build a register simply by taking a bunch of one-bit latches and putting them all together, making sure that they're all using the same clock signal, and we'll have the same sort of data value coming in and the same value coming out. And so these will essentially some feedback loops in here that will allow us to store the old value of the register for the next cycle. So these lines that are coming in are used to set the register values, and these lines coming out are used to read the register value. And these registers are connected by these groups of wires or these buses to other components. So this is a component here called a splitter, which takes a multi-bit input and splits it into the individual bits, or takes the individual bits and combines them back into a multi-bit output. And as we said before, if we design these latches correctly, they will use edge triggering to allow computation to stabilize. So basically, at the rise of the next clock signal, the output of the previous cycle will be locked in. And so anything that's coming in on these lines here will be the output from previous computation, and it'll be locked in when the clock signal rises. And then that value will stay there during the execution so that it can be read out and used for the rest of used by the rest of the logic, which will probably be mostly combinational, to calculate the new values for the next cycle. And this will just keep repeating over and over again.